Namaste and welcome to our English class again. Today also we are doing the same poem, The Road Not Taken, from Unit 9, page number 94. Yes, so we have done this poem the day before and we finished reading it. And today we are doing the activities related to this poem, and I have said you to do those activities as your homework also. I hope you have gone through the activities and you tried to do that. Okay, it is on your page number 95 and 96 of your course book, of your textbook. Now, before going to the exercise, let's talk something about the poem. Okay. Okay, this poem is written by Robert Frost. Robert Frost is an American poet, okay? And this poem is, I have just said you in previous classes also, that this poem is most taught poem, yes, most read poem in school level, in colleges, because it is very, very, very sweet poem, okay? And we can relate this poem to our life also, okay? Here, in this poem, there is one traveler, yes, it's a yatru tha, okay? He is going through the jungle, okay? He is walking through the jungle, there he finds two way, okay? Two diverse way, then he is in dilemma now, he is in confusion in which way to walk, yes? There is one traveler, he is walking through the jungle, okay, and he find two road there, okay, he find two road there and he is in confusion that in which road he has to travel, yes, in which road he has to go, then, but what is the main problem here about the traveler is that he want to travel in both road, yes? He want to travel in both road, but he couldn't. Yes? So, he stand in front of the diverse road and thinks a lot which road to travel. Then finally, he decide to travel the second road and he goes back. He goes up. Yes? He decided to travel the second road. But what say, again, same time what he says, although I know that this way will take to the next way, then again there will be next way, I will reach far away in the destination. Dhere para puksu, euta road bada arko road bada arko road connection bada tada pugeta pani, bholi ma farkera aera tyo road chha, ke garna sakchu? Arko road ma hinna sakchu, ekina pani ma duitai road hinna chahanchu. He said that is the saying, okay? And what happens, he thinks in which road he will have to go, then he chooses the second one, then at the finally, okay, in the last time, in two lines, okay, he find that he has taken the road which is less travel and that has made his life difference. Yes, that is all about the poem. It is written here, look here, I took the one less traveled by and that has made all the difference. Okay, this is all about the poem that we did in our previous class, and this was only the short revision of the poem. Okay, let's go to our exercise today. I hope you have done it your home, some of you. If you have done at your home, then please turn your exercise book or the course book where you have done, and I will be doing it for you today. Then we will tally it, okay? Or if you have not done, then please turn page number 95. Be ready with your copy and pencils, and we will be doing right now, okay? Now, look, page number 95, vocabulary in use, okay? Now, look here. Okay, you can look at the board also, or you can look at your book also there, okay? Following words describe either of the two roads the poet is talking about in the poem, okay? There are some words that talk about, that describes the road, okay, that is in the poem, okay? Fill the table below using appropriate word or words given below. What are the words? Bent in the undergrowth, fair. Okay, it's better, not better, okay, it is B-E, better, okay, then grassy, worn, trodden black, then less traveled, okay, these are the words. You can also look at your book also. Now, you have to separate these words in these two columns, okay, the first says the first road and the second says the second road, okay. Then, look at the poem once again. Look at the slide here. Look here. First line, two roads diverged in a low wood. Okay. And sorry, I couldn't travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down one. One means the first road. Okay. One, as far as I could, to where it bent in the undergrowth. That means, bent in the undergrowth. Which road bent in the undergrowth? The first one. Yeah. So, we will be writing here, bent in the undergrowth, Okay, we will be writing here bent in the undergrowth. Okay, then what is the next word? Fair. Now look at the poem again, once again. Yes, then took the other. Other means the second one. Okay, just as, sorry, then took the other. Other means the next road, the second road, is just as fair. Then this fair is connected with the second road. Yes, so we will put this fair in second road. F A I R. Okay, now next one. Sorry. And having perhaps the better claim. Okay, what claim? Better claim. The better is connected with second road. Yes, so better will be also placed in the second road. Better here. Then next word is grassy. Yes, look at the third line in second stanza. Because it was grassy. Now this stanza is this, then this three line, they are talking about the second road. Then obviously we can say that this grassy, it is talking about, it is connected to the second road. Okay, so grassy also here. Now look here. Though is for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. Okay, now the same, them. Though is for that the passing there, okay. I'm sorry. Though is for that the passing there had warned them really about the same. That means this one is connected with the both road, first and second. So we can say that this one comes under the first road and the second road both. Okay, then the next word is trodden black. Okay, look at the third stanza. And both that morning equally lay. Now again the poet is talking about the both road in the morning. Okay, so the both room and both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. That means both road, it is again talking about both road. That means trodden black is connected with both. Okay, you can write here also. That. Oh, then look at the poem again. Oh, I kept the first for the another day and yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubt if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two road diverged in a wood and I took one less travel by. Okay, now the poet is talking about the second road here. The second road is less traveled in comparison to the first one, he says. So it is one less traveled, it is connected with the second road, so less traveled here. Clear? Got it? Oh, okay, yes. Now we finish this vocabulary in use, we have the words bent in undergrowth, yes, fair, better, grassy, worn, trodden black and less travel. Then bent in the undergrowth, worn, trodden black, we kept in the first road. Then second, fair, better, grassy, worn, trodden black and less travel. Yes. We have divided these words in such a way. Now let's go to the next exercise in the vocabulary use only. That is, match the following words with the meaning. Yeah, it is there. So let's do that. I will be placing the words first, then we will be doing the, we will be keeping the meaning there. What are the words? Number one, A, diverged. What is the word? Diverged. Yeah? B number, it is wood. Number B is? Wood. Yes? Number C, undergrowth. Undergrowth, yeah. Number D, claim. Number D is claim. Number E, sigh. Number E is Sai. Number F is Trudan. Number Z is Bent. Number S is Hens. Yes for Hens. Okay. Now, meanings, okay, I will be placing here. Meanings of these words. What shall we do is that there is written the number also. I will be placing the meaning, okay, in front. I won't be doing this way and that way. I will just keep in front, okay. Just you look at the book and you match it there, okay. It is like this. Then what does divorced mean first? Divorced means, we talked a lot about that. Divorced means separated, yes? Branched away. Divorced means separated or branched away. Road, that is branched away. Okay, separated or road, that is branched away. Yes. Then, next word is wood. Wood means forest. It is in number 5, okay, in your book. If you are going to this, do in this way line, then you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 number there is wood. Yes, forest. Okay, sorry. The wood means forest. Wood means forest, okay. The next one is undergrowth. You know undergrowth? Undergrowth. Yes, you know that. We have talked about it. The jungle ma huncha ni jhari jaha chai san sana the plants haru huncha small small bushes, yes, bas of plants, that is undergrowth, okay? Then undergrowth means shrubs, a mass of bushes. Next one is claim. Claim means demand. Claim means demand. I think this arrow is not perfect right now. We will keep right later on, okay? The next one is sigh. Sigh means this type of acting, okay? Taking long breath. This is sigh, okay? Sigh, a long and deep breath. Sigh, a long and deep breath. Next one is trodden. Trodden means walked on. Hiniyeko baneko, okay? Okay? Trodden means walked on. Okay? Next one is bent. Bent, you know? This is straight, this is bent, okay? That means curved. Curved, okay? And hence means tyadehi upranta bhaneko, okay? Okay, from and now on, okay? From now on, that is hence. Now let's match it. I was about to keep it straight, but it is not possible here, okay? Mm-hmm. Yes. Branched, wood means diverged, branched away, okay? Wood, forest. Undergrowth, serves a mass of bushes, okay? Claim, demand, okay? Sigh, a deep and long breath. Trodden, walked on. Bent, curved. And hence, from now on, okay? Hence, from now on. Look at the book, at your book also, okay? Diverged. Diverged means a branched away, wood, forest, undergrowth, soft or a mass of bushes, okay? In mass the word, this is the mass the following, okay? You can mass in such a way also, but I have kept it here straightforward. Look, A diverged, A, words A diverged is massed with meaning number 3 branched away, okay? So you can mass in that way also. Diverged, branched away, wood, forest, yes? Undergrowth, a soft or mass of a bushes, okay? Claim, demand, sigh, a deep and a long breath, trodden, walked on, bent, carved, hence, from now on. Okay, this is all about mass the following. I'm sorry. Now, turn the page number 96 there, reading comprehension. There we have a fill in the blanks there. Look there. Okay, I will be taking it out first. Look at page number 96. Okay, reading comprehension 1 number. There is fill in the blanks using suitable words. There are some words given in the box also. Read those words now. There is list, travel, road, decisions, yes, difference, speaker, difficult, dilemma, choices. These words are there. Okay. Now, look at the reading comprehension, or you can look that at your book also, okay? There is no problem. Look here. Fill in the blanks using suitable words from the box, okay? You may need to use one word twice. That means you can use one word twice, two times, okay? Twice means two times. What are the words there? List, travel, road, decision, difference, speaker, difficult, dilemma, and choices, yes? Now look here, the poem is about a dash that the dash has faced. He has dashed between two dash. He compares both the dash, okay? He takes a long time to take the final dash. It is dash for him. Finally, he chooses the dash that has made dash in his life, okay? Now, one second, shall we go through the poem? If so, then let's go. Look here. Two roads diverged in yellow wood, and sorry, I could not travel both. And be one traveler, long I stood and looked down on as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Now, who is the speaker in the poem? I'm sorry. Who is the speaker here? Sorry. The poem is about a confusion, yes? Look here, in the first line only it is written here, two roads diverged in a yellow wood, yes, and sorry I couldn't travel both. Two roads are diverged, duita road ki bako cha, chuttieko cha, and I couldn't travel both, yes, I can't go in both the road at the same time. That means he is in dilemma, he is in dilemma that the poem is about a dilemma that the speaker, okay, speaker has faced. He has choices, okay, he has choices between two roads. He compares both the roads. Now this road word, it is repeated, okay? Twice we are using the word, okay? He compares both the roads. He takes a long time to take the final decision. He takes the long time to take the final decision. It is difficult for him. It is difficult for him. Finally, he chooses the which road? least traveled road. Yes, he chooses the least traveled traveled road that has made a difference in his life. That has made a difference in his life. Okay, the poem is about a dilemma that the speaker has faced. He has chosen between two roads. He compares both the roads. He takes a long time to take the final decision. It is difficult for him. Finally, he chooses the least traveled road that has made a difference in his life. Okay, this is all about fill in the blanks here. Then, now we have the rhyming words here. Okay, two number, what it says? Find the words from the poem which rhyme with the words given below. Do you know what is in my rhyming word? Rhyming. For example, look at the poem here. Okay. Here look here. Would, stood, could. Yes. Would, stood, could. Both, undergrowth. Yes. Fear, where, there. Claim, same. Yes. Lay, day, way, black, back, okay? Sigh, I, by, hence, difference. These words that sound similar, okay? And that gives the rhythm, okay? That is said to be rhyming words, okay? Now, look here. And then what it is said there, find the words from the poem which rhyme with the words given below, okay? It is said there, and there is also given the examples also, okay? I have brought in here, look here. What are the words? Would, stood, and could. That is given here as an example. Then you have to write the rhyming words of fear, day, and sigh. Look at the book. Look at the poem. Okay, you can look at the book also, or you can look at the slide here also. You have to find fear. Where is here? Yes, it's here. Look, the second stanza, the first line. Fear, okay. Then where, there. Fear, where, W-E-A-R, where, then T-H-E-R-E, there. Fear, where, there. Okay. Next one is day. Where is day? Yes, day, it is in third stanza, third line. Yeah, oh, I kept the first for the other day. Then we have day, lay, way. In third stanza, we have these three words. Look at your book, stanza third, okay? At both the morning equally lay. Yes, in leaves on stave had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, lay, day. At knowing how way leads on to way. Yes, way. Now, next one is sigh. It's in last stanza, second line. I shall be telling this with sigh. Okay, somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in wood and I. Okay, sigh, I. Okay, I took the one less traveled by. Okay, by. So these are the rhyming words. Fair, where, there, day, lay, way, sigh, I, bye. Okay. Now it's turn off. Let's do the, yes, it's turn off question answer now. Look, page number 96, reading comprehension, 3 number, read the poem again and answer these questions, okay? Okay.
Yes.
Answer this question. Who is the speaker in the poem? Now, who is the speaker of this poem? In this question, what student might write or what I find my student writing is that Robert Frost is the speaker in the poem, okay? He is the writer of the poem. He is the poet, okay? So who is the speaker? That means one person who is traveling. Euta manche jo hirdai cha ni hirera ta jungle par gardai cha jungle ma dui ta bato bhetcha ni u chai vastama speaker ho nta. So we will write a traveler. Who is the speaker? A traveler. A traveler, okay, is a speaker. Who is the speaker? A traveler. A traveler is the speaker in the poem, okay? Who is the speaker? A traveler is the speaker in the poem, okay? Where is the speaker standing in this poem? Okay, that is the next question. Where is the speaker standing in this poem, okay? Now look here, look at the poem. Two road diverged in Ellwood, and sorry I couldn't travel both. To be one traveler, long I stood, okay? To be a traveler, long I stood and looked down one as far as I could. That means the traveler, there is one traveler, he is walking through the road, through the jungle, okay, in road, on road, and he finds two diverse road, two separated road. Now he is at in front of these two diverse road, okay, he is here. Where is he standing then? He is standing, okay, the speaker is standing in front of diverged road in the poem. The speaker is standing in front of diverged road in this poem, okay, clear? Next one is, why does he stop there for a long time? Now look here in the first stanza, and be one traveler, long I stood, okay, he stood for the long time, and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. That means why he stand in front of for a long time? To decide which route to travel. Yes, duita road ko agadi baseko ra u ke garecha duita road la para samma herekcha. Why? Because he want to travel both. Duitai ma hinnu parni hinna usko ichha cha tara ke cha badhyata euta ma matra hinna sakinchha ni ekchoti. So to decide which road to travel, he was standing there. He stops, okay, he stops, stops, stops there for a long time to decide which road to travel, to decide which road to travel. Okay, next one. Why is he in dilemma? Why is he in dilemma? Okay, the udaharan kina cha, why is he in confusion? Because he doesn't know which road to travel. Same thing, okay. Why? Because he doesn't know which road to travel. Or you can write, he is in dilemma because he want to travel both road in at once. एकैचोटि हिँड्न चाहन्छ तर त्यो सम्भव छैन नि त. यस, सो यु क्यान राइट हि इज इन डिलेमा बिकज हि कान्ट डिसाइड द रोड टु ट्राभल, द रोड टु ट्राभल. ओके, विच रोड डज हि चुज टु ट्राभल? ओके, यु क्यान लुक एट द प्यासेज हियर. Yes, at the last line he has said, I took the one less troubled by, and that has made all the difference. If we go on through this poem from top to bottom, then we can find this least traveled road is the second road. Yeah, the least traveled road is the second road, because in third stanza he has said that both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. Yes, he has kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way. That means that day he doesn't travel the first one. Then obviously he chooses, okay, C-H-O-O-E-S, chooses, okay, the second road, the second road, road to travel. Okay. He chooses C-S-O-O-S-E-S. Okay. He chooses the second road to travel. Question number F, what is that? Yes, why does he leave the other one? That is the question, yeah? Why does he leave the other one? What is the F number question? Why does he leave the other one? Why? Okay? Because he finds the second road less traveled. Oh? So, second road jun thyo je thore manchele matra inne thye bato haru thore matra bhatkeko thyo bhane jasto kura cha ni ta. So he finds the second road less traveled. That's why he leaves the first one. Okay? He leaves the other one. He finds the second road. Why? Because he finds the second one less traveled. Okay. Is the speaker optimistic? You know, optimistic. Asavadi. Okay. Bhavishyapati asavadi dekhincha bhanne jasto kura cha. Is the speaker optimistic? Yes. Yes, we can say that. Why? Look here in the third stanza. And both the money equally lay in leaves. No step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day. It knowing how way leads on to way. Okay. He knows that one way leads to next. Next leads to next. And he goes very far. He can't come back. Okay. But also he says that tomorrow I will come and I'll walk the way. Yes, euta bato le arko bato lagera dherai para lana sakcha u pharkera naauna sakcha ni tara pani u ke bhanecha I will come and I will travel the road the next day. Yes, so we can say he is optimistic. Yes, what will write here? Yes, the speaker is optimistic. How can you say this? Yes, the poet promises to return and travel the other road next day. Okay, do you think he has made the right decision? Look at the last paragraph here. Okay, I doubt if I should ever be come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh. Somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood, and I took the one least traveled by, and that has made all the difference. That means, if the life has been made difference by the decision taken right now, then obviously we can say that he has made the right decision. Oh, aaja lieko decision ke bhayo ta. भोलि चाहिँ के भएको रहेछ डिफरेन्स बनाएको रहेछ लाइफ परिवर्तन भएको रहेछ भने अभियसली वी क्यान से द्याट यस ही हेज मेड द राइट डिसिजन सो द एन्सर विल बी यस ओके नेक्स्ट वान वाट डु यु थिङ्क द रोड रिफर टु रोड रिफर से वी टक्ड अबाउट दिस थिङ्स इन आवर प्रिभियस क्लास अल्सो ओके द डे बिफोर वी टक्ड अबाउट दिस थिङ्स अल्सो द रोड रिफर्स टु डिसिजन वी हेभ टु मेक इन आवर लाइफ. Okay, the roads refer to decision we have to make in our life. Okay, decisions or alternatives. Okay, we find in every step of our life. In every step of our life. Okay, what is the central idea of the poem? What is the main thing? What is the crux? Main idea that is talking about. The poem le bhanna khojeko mukhya kura ke ho bhanne socha. Okay, this might be the important question also. what is the central idea of the poem? That means what is the central idea? That means we face problem, that means we find alternative in every step of our life. We have to be very sensitive choosing the alternative so that we have to choose the correct alternative so that the life will be different, or that might make our life difference in the future. आजको करेक्ट डिसिजनले भोलिको लाइफ के डिफरेन्स बनाउन राम्रो बनाउन चाहिँ के गर्ने त गर्नुपर्छ भन्ने खालको सेन्ट्रल आइडिया हो. सो वाट विल यु राइट द सेन्ट्रल आइडिया अफ द पोएम इज अर यु क्यान राइट इन दिस वे अल्सो वी हेभ अर वान सुड नट वी हेभ वान सुड चुज correct alternatives so that life can be different in upcoming future. Okay, in upcoming future. Or we can write in a next word also that we have to be sensitive while choosing the alternative so that the life can be different. Okay, you can write in your own way also. We can make this answers in any way. Ever in confusion, okay, if it is like that, then you can share it to your class. Now recite the poem in a group and paraphrase it. Okay, please teachers, you please help your student to recite the poem. Okay, this very beautiful poem, very very sweet lines are there. We can recite it, or we can just, if you go through the YouTube, you can find the lyrical song also. Okay, it is uploaded there as a song also. You can find song of this, The Road Not Taken also. Okay, it is also very sweet. And paraphrase it, that means student, please try to write this word, this poem in your own words. And please, you teacher, please help your student to do so. And number three is, what message do you think the poet wants to convey to the readers? Okay, we have gone through all this poem, then we come to know that the writer says that there are so many alternatives, so many choices in the life, so we have to think a lot before choosing a thing. Yes, as he stood in front of the diverse road and he thought a lot which road to go. In the same way, we have to think a lot before choosing the alternatives. Then we have to go through our alternatives so that we can make our life difference, we can have a happy life, or we can have a good life at the future. Okay, that is the main thing of the poem. So we went through this poem. Okay, we did the exercise today, we finished it, and I hope you have a good time with me also. And if you have done this exercise before also, you have compared that, or if you have not done, then I think you got the idea. Now you will be doing that. And please, you teachers, you please help your student to do the exercise, and please share it with each other. Okay, have a good time. Thank you. Good luck.